to improve the way that treatments are done. That power is enormous. In this country, we've got an opportunity, really, to be one of the leading countries in the world at using this new technology.
Increasing the use of AI will also pose challenges for the health service, from training staff to enhancing cybersecurity and ensuring patient confidentiality. James Gallagher, BBC News.
9 minutes to seven is the time. Thanks for joining us on Breakfast. I'm on my own on the sofa this morning because Charlie is in Edinburgh for the peak festival season. There are more than 1,000 shows taking place every day. Let's show you Edinburgh Castle. Look at that. Bathing in sunshine with a rather moody sky behind. Carol was telling us earlier that there is some rain in the forecast. Hopefully, Charlie, you'll get away with it, though. Good morning.
It is looking absolutely stunning here this morning. You're right, Niger. And I'm sort of listening in here because we've got Aquapella. We're doing a slightly mellow breakfast kind of a sound this morning. Have a little listen. Now, if you walk this way with me a little bit, we've got Gravity and Other Myths that come all the way from Australia. So take a look at these guys, because they've been waiting and gradually warming up and doing some of their routine this morning for us. You get the impression. I did offer to join in, but health and safety gave it an absolute no. It is spectacular, isn't it? I'm going to walk this way. Sophie's here, of course, this morning. Edinburgh Festival is an enormous event. 4 million people come here throughout the month of August. Tony Slattery is with me this morning.
Hello,
good morning, Tony.
Hi.
You're doing your show up here. That kind of thing, is that for you?
Yes, very much not. No, it's breathtaking, though.
Isn't it? At this time of day as well?
Yes.
It's not ideal for them.
Is it not?
No, that's what they say.
All fit as fiddles.
You're very welcome here this morning, Tony, because
you
have your show on here this year, and it's a very yours is a very personal story that you're telling through your comedy.
Well, sort of, because it's like 30 years, there was a programme called Whose Line Is It Anyway, and that's been revived, so I'm back with the pals doing some of the same games with Clive Anderson and lots of other people who might be remembered. And, yeah, I do get a round of applause when I come on, and it's a kind of nostalgic thing. Oh, he can walk unaided to the stage and not be stretchered on, but it's still fun.
But because those people are not familiar with your story, is it? You had a major breakdown, didn't you?
Oh, that's right, yes.
At the age of what? 36, is that right?
It was quite early, yes, because it was. I was lucky enough after going to university and meeting up with Emma Thompson and Hugh Laurie and Stephen Fry, and I don't know what's happened to them. I wish them the best luck
with their careers. Yeah, who knows?
Who knows? And then I got into work and then just worked too much, and the work led to bad things. In my case, I was being blunt about it, like drugs, then booze, and then depression, and then bipolarity. And I came through that with lots of professional help, and I owe my life to the NHS and some other people as well, especially my partner who might be watching, and so that's my story.
Yeah, and so this is part of that's part of your show, isn't it? People hear some of that as part of the show you're doing.
Well, there's a Whose Line Is It Anyway, which I've got a couple of days to do, but there's also, I'm doing a kind of Q&A with a very well-respected a comedy historian called Robert Ross, and it's called Slattery Will Get You Nowhere. Ha! And that's just exactly. But it's a question of the agreement between us. I don't want to know what he's going to ask me. I don't rehearse anecdotes. And the audience asks me anything I want. I just try and be as honest as I can.
And so you've been coming here to the Edinburgh Festival for a very long time.
Yes.
When were you first here?
I think the first time was 1979, when the Edinburgh Fringe Festival was approximately this thing.
Yes.
And now it's about that big, like 6,000 shows, and and happier times when 16 people were sleeping in a small room, and now
do you remember that whole thing of doing gigs in effectively no people?
I once did a gig to four people, and three of them walked out halfway through and asked for their money back, but the person who was the cashier had left with the money, so we had to take them to the pub.
Really?
And give them drinks, yes. That was then.
But that's where you earn your money. That's where you really do your time.
I think so.
You learn your craft.
Yes.
And, of course, comedians have become superstars now, haven't they? That's the other thing.
That used to be the phrase, isn't it? Comedy is the new rock and roll living, and indeed the comedy section of the Edinburgh Fringe is now the hugest, because people are, you know, trying to make it, and they're doing the Free Fringe and things like that, which is I'm also going to do, because I strongly believe in that. And basically, if you entertain people, they chuck some coins, or if they're feeling generous, a fiver and a bucket, and then we can all share it and things like that.
It is a joke you make yourself, isn't it? But just to confirm, you're sitting here on the sofa, Tony Slattery is not dead. That's what you said to me, the first thing you said. A lot of people say, I thought he was...
More or less, yes. I do get a sympathy round. You say, oh, bless him. he's still walking, bless him. And then you take it from there and just be silly and try and... With the improv, which I'm also doing with a chap called Alan Lear, again at the Free Fringe, is just to be silly and create joy. And I know that sounds a bit too over Disney-esque, but it's a good enough motive, isn't it?
And I'm itching to join in those guys behind, so I'll leave you free to do that. Lovely to see you here this morning. Thank you very much.
Bless you. Thank you very much.
Good to see you. And more reports from Edinburgh throughout the morning here this morning, right now. The news, travel and the weather, where you are.
Good morning. A major clear-up operation is underway after torrential rain caused flooding in various parts of Scotland last night. Five planes full of passengers were stuck for several hours at the Winterborough Tunnel in West Lothian.